everyone, your boy Core here, aka Crasher, bringing you guys a new exciting video, and ladies and gentlemen, let's get into this. Alright fam, so in today's video, allow me to present you guys with a very special one, and also a pretty big one too, because we have ourselves a follow-up to the 1K special where I put out a Q&A announcement for you guys, and it was 2 weeks ago today that I put out that video, so I gave you guys around 2 weeks to think of what it is that you want to ask and say, and this video here is to respond to what it is that you guys have said in the comments down below. And there is a lot to get to, so with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's get started. So first on the list, we have ourselves Estuardo Rudiez, and I do apologize in advance if I fuck up any pronunciations. I'm not good with pronunciating things sometimes, alright? Give me a break. The roast is, you bring everyone so much joy when you leave the room. Oh man! Woohoo! I gotta say, that was a pretty good attempt right there, but it's like, you know, come on, man. Gotta have a little more substance than that, you know what I'm saying? But you know what? It's a playful roast. No, little jab. I like it. Up next is Nat Neil. We have ourselves question. What is your favorite generation of Pokemon? That would be Generation 3, my friend. Generation 3 is just absolute top-notch, man. Too many memories to get into in this video, so I'm gonna just leave it at that. And the roast is, my phone battery lasts longer than your relationships. Oh-ho-ho! Damn! Team Leader Mimikyu is up next. Sometimes whenever I eat M&Ms, I like to hold two M&Ms in between my fingers and squeeze them as hard as I can until one of the M&Ms crack. I eat the cracked one, and the other one that didn't crack becomes the champion. Then I grab another M&M and force it to compete with the champion in this deadly game of M&M Gladiators. I do this until I run out of M&Ms, and when there's only one left standing, I send a letter to M&M's brand with the champion M&M in it with a note attached that reads, "Please use this M&M for breeding purposes." Okay. Pretty interesting read right there, my friend. Talian's Gucci, I know I fucked up that pronunciation, says, question, who inspired you to become a YouTuber and what name will you give your subscribers? It's me, Ares, by the way. I just changed my name. Hey, Ares, long time no see, buddy. How you doing, man? So who inspired me to become a YouTuber? Oh man, there's so many of them that have inspired me that there's a lot of names on the list. I'm just gonna rattle off a few off the top of my head. Shady Penguin, Shofu, PewDiePie, and also I really, really enjoy content from the likes of Polkarath and Lumia's trainer Zach. Like, those guys are recently inspirations of mine as well, especially on my main channel where I do a lot of anime-based content as well. And what name will you give your subscribers? Well, I call y'all legends, you know what I'm saying? I figure that's a pretty appropriate name for you guys because of the amount of support that you guys have given both of my channels. You guys are absolute legends, man. Don't you ever forget it. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, Fahad asks a question. Do you have a gaming channel? Well, technically speaking, my first channel, Crasher Plays and Reacts, is a partial gaming channel, although I've been doing a lot of reaction and review type of videos on there, but I have been getting back into the gaming scene with Super Mario Maker 2, so yes, I do have a gaming channel, technically speaking. Up next, ladies and gentlemen, we have Steven asking a question. If Sinnoh remakes become a thing, and if they reintroduce Mega Evolution, what Gen 4 Pokemon would you like to see get a Mega? That would be Yanmega, you know what I'm saying? Like, I love Yanmega as a Pokemon as is, it's really freaking cool, and it's got a killer shiny as well, but just imagine what it would be like with a Mega Evolution. I think that would be pretty damn cool. Burn, you pump less iron than broccoli puts in people when they eat it. Oof, oh damn. This is a nice little shot right there. Team Leader Mimikyu is up next and asks the question, what is your favorite meme? Well, one of my favorite memes would be the surprised Pikachu face. I definitely love that meme right there. Next up, we have TimeWarp123 asking a question. You plan on playing Animal Crossing? Well, to be honest with you, I'm not really familiar with Animal Crossing, and, you know, I haven't really played any of the games from the franchise. But, you know, never say never, you know what I'm saying? And we have ourselves Estuardo back again to roast. Your face makes onions cry. Ooh, damn. Nice little jab there, I like it. Austin Fritz is up next with a question. What is your favorite Pokemon type? I'm going with the Steel type, man. They have so many resistances, man. And there's also some really cool looking steel type Pokemon, you know what I'm saying? I love Metagross along with Mega Metagross, Steelix, Scizor, you know, the list goes on. Steel types are the way to be, baby. Red Soul Determination is up next. Here's my question. If you could say anything to your younger self, what would it be? And that is actually a really good question as well. What would I say to my younger self? That would be, if you want to be a YouTuber, start your dreams a lot earlier than you did. You know what I'm saying? And also, all of those people that you come across in high school, they're not going to be in your life after high school, man. So don't, you know, take to heart what they have to say and just do you, champ. That's pretty much the gist of what I would say to my younger self, to be honest with you. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, is a Freddy Fazbear fan 123, and here's my question. First, I'd like to thank you for your great content. It matters a lot to me. Thanks, man. Second, I have three questions for you to answer. Number one, in Pokemon Sword and Shield, what do you think Raihan's personality will be along with his voice? That's a really good question. I think he's gonna be kind of a showboaty type because, you know, in Pokemon Sword and Shield, he does the whole selfie thing with his Rotom phone before he Gigantamaxes his Pokemon, so I think he's gonna be very much into himself. Probably not, like, overly arrogant and all that stuff, and I'm thinking that his voice, he's probably gonna sound like some sort of sports star, like maybe a basketball player or something like that. That's really the best way I can answer that. Number two, do you think we could see Karina versus Raihan? Highly doubt it, but it is a possibility, so, you know, never say never, right? Number three, are you planning to react to those Mew and Mewtwo comic dubs that I sent you anytime soon? Don't worry, man, those are in the works, believe it, you know what I'm saying? And also, we have ourselves a roast. Your face was so ugly, Mewtwo ran in the other direction. Come on, man. Joking, that's not true at all. I think any girl would be lucky to have you. I appreciate that, you know? Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves Dark96744 stating, after this lockdown ends, when are you gonna visit Hawaii, bro? And for the love of all that is sane, stay away from spicy meat sausages. Hey, come on, man, I love spicy sausages, you know what I'm saying? When am I gonna visit Hawaii? Well, that's a really good question. I've always wanted to know what Hawaii is like, but as for when I would ever plan on visiting Hawaii, that's a good question. Probably when you know, I'm rich, you know what I'm saying? That's really the best way I can answer that. Next up, we have ourselves a Jet Rider. Question, when are you gonna do more Super Mario Maker? Well, I've recently been doing more Super Mario Maker 2 content on my other channel, and I've got other videos lined up in the next few days in regards to that game. Roast, your age more than a primate and a volcanic eruption combined. Well, you're not too far off, man. You're not too far off. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves the Elemental Cat. What was your first ever Pokemon game? Pokemon Blue, my friend. Pokemon Blue. Also, what made you come up with the name Crasher? Well, to be honest with you, I gotta say, you know, Crasher Wake was the ultimate inspiration. You know what I'm saying? Not only is he a wrestler, which is something that I'm very much into. I love wrestling. You know, I love the WWE. But he also has a very, like, out there kind of personality and all that stuff, right? And also, he loves water types, which is my second most favorite typing in Pokemon. And honestly, it's like, you know what? It's like, the name Crasher sounds pretty fitting for me, but I gotta put on a lot of muscle, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've had the name Crasher for years now, you know what I mean? That's really where it all came from, was Crasher Wake, a Pastoria Gym. Next up, we have ourselves Sorafire Soul, and he says, so when you planning on doing the DK rap, lol, do you think you will ever do a Mario Maker viewers level or a mix of playing viewers levels and random ones? Well, to answer your question about the DK rap, I haven't really thought too much about it, if I'm gonna be completely honest, but I will say never, you know what I'm saying? And when do I plan on doing a Mario Maker viewer level? That's a good question. I might do a future live stream where I play the levels that the live viewers submit to me. So that way it can be a really unique and engaging sort of experience, right? Next up, we have ourselves Estuardo coming back again with two roasts. I'm not a nerd. I'm just smarter than you. Well, all right. I don't know how to respond to that one. It made me laugh, though. Roast, you are run too slow. I run faster than you. Well, I wouldn't doubt that, man. Like, I can't run to save my life. You know what I mean? I'm incredibly out of shape. especially with the whole quarantine thing and the gym closures and all that stuff. I haven't been able to exercise at all, which really kind of frustrates me. I can't keep up on my fitness, damn it. Rob Kim now chimes in and says, what is one video you always wanted to post on this channel but couldn't? The fact that we hit 1 million subscribers. I can't post that video because it's not true. We didn't hit 1 million subscribers, and it would be incredibly clickbaity, and there'd be a lot of people mad at me, and I don't want to make people get mad at me. That wouldn't be very fun for my neck. You know what I mean? I don't want to do that shit. I want to make the video when we actually do hit 1 million subs. Next up, we receive Seth Beecher with a few questions. Who or what inspired you to start making content? Well, as for who, I gotta give it to the likes of Shofu, PewDiePie, Shetty Penguin, and more recently, the likes of ThePokeRaf and Lumia's trainer, Zach. Now, what inspired me to make content? Well, see, the thing is, I haven't really been good at a lot of things in my life. And I wanted to try my hand at, creating content to inspire and entertain people. And when I started gaining some traction on that, I'm like, you know what? This is what I want to do. So, ever since then, that's kind of been, like, one of my big time main inspirations would be to inspire and entertain people. What is your favorite game franchise? I definitely love Nintendo, you know what I'm saying? Favorite ice cream flavor? I definitely love vanilla, you know what I'm saying? I love vanilla, very simple, straightforward, and delicious flavor. Also really versatile, too. PokeLover104 is up next. Not officially, but I was really interested. So, what happened to your dear basement? Well, the thing is, I had to do a change of scenery and move up here because my neighbors had issues with, the noise that I was making, I guess. Because their bedroom was like right next to the wall, which was right next to where I was shooting my video, so I can kind of understand where they were coming from there. So I've been up here for like over 3 years, and there hasn't really been much issues ever since, not since last summer and all that stuff, but we ain't gonna get into that because everything's all good now, you know what I'm saying? In what ways do your mascots Incineroar and Metagross mean to you besides looking like total badasses? Well, Metagross has been a long time favorite since I played Pokemon Sapphire. Like, at first when I was going into the game Pokemon Sapphire, I didn't know anything about it, you know what I mean? Like, I wasn't even aware that it existed when I seen that it did. I'm like, oh my god, Dad, like, I want to get this game, you know? And when I got it, you know, I absolutely knew nothing about it. And I absolutely fell in love with it. And when I got to Champion Steam and I seen they sent out Metagross, I was thinking, what the hell is that thing? It looks so cool, I want one. And that's pretty much how it all came to fruition when it came to my love for Metagross. And as for Incineroar, well, Incineroar sticks with me for a different reason because I have people telling me that I remind them of Incineroar, such as Jason as an example. He calls me his Incineroar, and Incineroar is known as a heel Pokemon, meaning that, you know, he is a heel wrestler. Heel is a term for bad guy in the wrestling business. But here's the thing, is that even though I like to play a heel, I'm not actually a bad guy, you know what I mean? You're so bad at knee choking, I bet Steelix could do better than you. Well, it wouldn't even be a knee choke for Steelix, it'd be like a tail choke or something like that, you know? But your neck would be crushed to a million pieces if Steelix tried that shit. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, ourselves, Andre JHD. What is your goal on YouTube? To be able to do this full time, my friend, to be able to inspire and entertain full time, because it would be an absolute dream job, you know what I'm saying? At least my hair isn't licked by a cow. Oh, come on, man, don't be dissing the flow. I love my hair, man, come on. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, ourselves, Ollie Maitland with a question. What are your hopes for the future of the Pokemon anime? I just hope it keeps on going, you know what I'm saying? And I really, really love the direction that Pokemon Journeys is going. It is completely unpredictable and absolutely hyped. It's like they haven't really missed a beat or put out any really bad episodes, honestly. I really enjoy the anime, honestly. Roast. It's really hard to roast you, my man, but it's harder to like your videos. Please don't take offense. You're a really great guy, and I love your videos. Aw, come on, man. It's a roast. You're allowed to roast me. And Rom even says, it's a roast. Don't apologize, you goof. But I gotta say, I really appreciate the words, man. I really appreciate that. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a Waddles Gaming with the question, would you play Pokken Tournament DX and why? I have tried that game out. It was pretty alright, but honestly, it kind of got boring for me really quickly. Now as for the roast, you make time making weightlifting videos, and Ash just carries like a hippopotamus who is like 300 plus pounds, and look the difference between the muscle gain of Crasher and Ash. Oh man. You know what though, I do kind of wonder how Ash is able to carry like heavy Pokemon without breaking a sweat or, you know, breaking his bones, you know what I'm saying? Like, holy cow. Anime logic though, am I right? Next up, we have ourselves Wrong Kin, and what the hell did he just write out here? It sounds like we got a song on our hands. Like, look at this. What is this, like a diss track or something? What the hell? Oh my god. Alright, well let's see if we can get through this wall of text here. Your subs are all fearing to stop the infamous Wrong Kin. From Alucard 808 to Sky Knight of Man, every sub will hear Wrong Kin. Got this perseverance. Since my friends cried Wrong Kin, thought this was your win till you fought with Wrong Kin. Roast me one-on-one, tournament of roasts have just begun. They already cower to my roast where I'm from, so everybody now just wants to run. Roast rain from up above, I brush these subs under the rug, like dust on my hands or Swordfire Soul, even Silver the Fox won't see any love. It was boring with your crew, so I guess I'll go ahead and let you power up. Yeah, I'm stopping what you roast, and I don't even have to respond, so you out of luck. By the time I'll be through, Crasher, yeah, you're gonna want to self-destruct. From Pokemon Showdown to 6-0, goddamn, your Incineroar sucks. It's over. Roast Instinct got you a bit closer. I take a step back, saying it's over. With my roast impact, I'm bringing roast unmatched, so I'll let you roast first. Roast is justice in my mind's eye. Seeing them watch from the sideline. Roast is justice in my mind's eye. So you'll be watching from the sideline. Holy cow. I love the flow of this so far. Let's keep going. Your subs are all fearing to stop the infamous Wrong Kin from Alucard 808 to Sky Knight of Man. Okay, this must be the chorus here. Let's go on to, oh jeez, here we go. Roast me 2-on-1. Tournament of roast only halfway done. I got a hunger for dominance and my eyes look bigger than my stomach cause I'm filled with disgust. If you set to roast, I'ma show it's brave what makes honor real. Cause roast and insults bend to my will. Like the roast they do cause they lack the skill to rumble with this muscle, the proudest warrior crumble. Jason, sit down, be humble, go to sleep. Crashers meet and roast, your sister's in double trouble. I mediate out of boredom, I'm turning red while you're embarrassed from all your struggle. Oh damn, got a lot of tongue twisters up in this, I'm telling you. See, I do this for my roast and my comedy, how I won't lose another friend or subs into martyrs, refuse to falter. Roast is running through me like it's water, pushing harder, proving to these subs I'm a universal monster. I'll let you roast first. Roast is justice in my mind's eye. See them watching from the sidelines. Roast is justice in my mind's eye. So you'll be watching from the sidelines. And we have ourselves another chorus. And oh my god. Holy cow, Rom. That is some really good, like, flow right here. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm picturing this. Sounds really fucking solid, honestly. Roasting me 3-on-1. Tournament of roasts are nearly done. Yes, I know I got the speed you want. I can just blink to see Time Warp's 1-2-3's roast. I'm a man whose roasts are just, and I even got to speak so much. We've been doing a lot of speaking so far. Letting my roast talk when we discuss, so that's why your jaw will be keeping shut. Feed me a challenge, I'll roast y'all down, cause you easily bowing. I'm leaving any of my friends who are weakest around me, with all these subs and supreme mods astounded. Alone in roasts on the peak of the mountain, defeat is never a feasible route. When I need all the roasts to see my wish founded, I shatter my boundaries, Wrong Kin the Blue, you might as well jump. Roast is justice in my mind's eye, seeing them watching from the sidelines, and it goes on to repeat right here. Woohoo! Wow, I gotta say, man, that wasn't just a roast, that was a fucking diss track, man. Oh my god, man, dude, that was 10 out of 10 right there, man. That was crazy. Alright, so that totally didn't wind me out. Holy cow, that was a lot to read. But next up, we have ourselves two blanks here saying, loved it. Okay, must be a deleted account or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Who doesn't get those comments anyways of loved it or want to be friends or whatever? But anyways, Estuardo is coming back for, like, I lost track of how many times this guy's coming back. Roast. I'm not strong than you. I'm stronger than you. Okay. And Estuardo also asks, what is your best Pokemon in all time? One of them definitely being Incineroar, but as for, like, the best Pokemon, I can't narrow it down to just one, man. I mean, I've got a lot of top favorites. I can't pick one out of all of them, you know what I'm saying? Next up, we have ourselves MMS Bloodhound with this. Have you tried kombucha? If not, would you want to try it someday? Absolutely, you know what I'm saying? But I don't think I'm gonna go as far as to pour it all over myself and freak out over Patreon deleting me and all that stuff, right? And moving on, you're so unlucky you ain't gonna get a shiny Pokemon even if Game Freak buffs the shiny rate to 99%. Oh man, well, you know what? I can believe it though, in all honesty, because so far in Pokemon Sword and Shield, my attempts to get a shiny Pokemon have come up zero. Zero shinies so far, man. The only shinies I would be getting would be from other people, man. But the day, hopefully, when I do get a shiny, it will be for everyone to see. Estuardo asks the question, what made you come up with the name Crasher on your YouTube channel? And, well, Romkin actually already answered that. But yeah, basically, Crasher Wake was my main inspiration since he's into wrestling. And he's got a very out there kind of personality. And he also loves water types, which is my second favorite typing, honestly. So I pretty much was inspired by Crasher Wig to, have the nickname of Crasher, if you know what I'm saying. So next up, we have ourselves Awesome Ocelot with 11 questions. Holy cow. So question number one, what's your favorite Pokemon of each generation? I can't really answer that off the top of my head, but what I'm thinking about doing now that we're on this subject, I might actually do like a mini series where I do a top 5 list of each favorites from every generation. You know what I mean? Question number two, what's your favorite Pokemon of each type? Again, that sounds like a good video idea. So I might turn that into a future video on my other channel. What is my opinion on Generation 5? I think it's really, really good. I love the music, I love the story, and you know, aside from a few questionable designs when it comes to Pokemon, I think Gen 5 really, really is solid, you know what I'm saying? It does get, you know, a bit of hate and criticism and all that stuff, which is fine, because no generation's ever perfect, but Generation 5 is definitely, definitely really good. Number four, what's your favorite episode of Pokemon Journey so far? That is a good question. One of my top favorites would happen to be episode 10, I think it is, the one where Ash catches a fully evolved Dragonite, man. That is absolute madness. And favorite moment, I'd have to say when, it's actually, there's two favorite moments of mine, two out of many. One of them would be when Go and Raboot made up and they, they actually care about one another. That was in episode 22 where we had ourselves Go, you know, worrying about Raboot and whether or not Raboot liked him. But turns out Raboot is just, you know, not one to show its emotions. And also, I gotta say, another favorite moment of mine would be when Ash hatched Riolu, man. Oh my god, that was just absolutely crazy. Like, that was huge, honestly. Number five, what's your favorite non-Pokemon video game franchise? I'd have to say, you know, Mario is definitely up there, you know what I'm saying? Very versatile, very fun, and definitely brings back a lot of good childhood memories. What's your favorite animal, real life, not Pokemon? I'd have to say, one of my top favorites would be a Komodo dragon, but I also love lions as well. Number seven, what's your favorite music theme from a main series Pokemon game? Definitely one of my top favorites would happen to be Team Skull Boss Guzma, like when you go to battle him and stuff like that. Like, as soon as the beat drops, man, it's like, you know you're gonna be in for a crazy battle. Like, it's just absolutely crazy. I love when the beat drops. It sounds like also that a diss track is about to come about. It's really awesome. What's your favorite Pokemon that Ash owns? I can't really think of a top favorite, but I might do like a top 5 or a top 10 video of my favorite Pokemon that Ash owns. But I gotta say, Incineroar is definitely one of them, you know what I'm saying? What was the first Pokemon game you ever played? Pokemon Blue, my friend. Have you ever caught a shiny Pokemon? Yes, I've caught quite a few of them, you know, especially on my Mega Crasher channel, where I did a lot of live streams for Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee. Number 11, what's your favorite video you've reacted to on the channel so far? That's a good question. I'd say Terminal Montages, Legendary and Mythical Pokemon Battle Royal. That's definitely one of my top favorites. Now let's move on to the roast. Well, I'm not really good at roasting you as I'm way too nice, so have a roast chicken instead. Ah, gotta love that protein. Trivia, Furret is the size of a grown male adult at 5'11", and Charizard is only 5'7". Well, I'm 5'6", so I'm an inch shorter than Charizard. Next up, we ourselves a Ghost Fox here. Question, why do you think you're not superior to a fox? Is that supposed to be a trick question, man? Because here's the thing, man, as a T-Rex, as a lion, as a Komodo dragon, and as a carnivore, man, foxes are not safe, so, you know, if I'm hungry and I happen to be on the hunt and I see a fox, well, guess what? Foxes is about to become dinner. Roast, your knees are so chickeny, I still ask why they cross the road. I think you mean they cross the road? Oh my god. You and your chicken knees, man. Like, I'm the one with the beefy knees. You got the mosquito knees, alright? Forget chicken knees, you got the mosquito knees. Next up, we ourselves, Weston Pickering. What is your favorite of Ash's gym battles? Mine is third black and white gym leader. I gotta say, one of the gym battles that I am absolutely fond of is actually the battle between Volkner and Ash. You know, where you had Infernape versus Luxray. That right there was the episode where Infernape's Blaze actually didn't take him over. Like, he was actually able to get control of it. And I thought that was a very pivotal moment right there in Infernape's development through the Gen 4 anime series. I thought that was a really good battle, in all honesty. Next up, we are still using Nitroflame 250. Hey, Crasher, what is up? So, since I don't know how to roast people good, I'll just give a few questions instead. Fair enough. Question number one, have you ever thought of reacting to other animes besides Pokemon? I don't care what anime it would be, but it would be something else to react to that is not Pokemon all the time. That is an anime, though. Well, I recently started doing a live stream series where I would live review and live react to My Hero Academia, and we are going to be doing episode 5 the next time that I go live on my other channel. Question number two, do you plan on continuing your shiny hunting on Pokemon Sword with either hatching that shiny Litten to get your shiny Incineroar mascot for YouTube or working on hunting for a shiny Galarian Zigzagoon? I definitely do plan on it. I've just been focused on trying a bunch of different things to see what works for the channel and what works for you guys as well. Question number three, if Canada was to become a Pokemon region in a future Pokemon game, what part of Canada would you want them to use? Not all of Canada, but any part of it from your own choosing. Definitely Nova Scotia. I would definitely love to see a region that is based on the Maritimes. I think that would be absolutely awesome. Next up, we ourselves, Chaz Johnson, with the question, how old are you? I'm 29 and I'm turning 30 September 25th this year. Oh my god, I can't believe that I'm gonna be in my dirty 30s come September 25th this year. God damn it! I'm gonna miss my 20s, man! And last but not least, we have ourselves Lauren. Question, who is your favorite Gen 8 Pokemon? Roast, how are monkeys things better than you? Love you. Aw, I love you too, little score bunny. My favorite Gen 8 Pokemon, definitely one of them is Eternatus, you know what I'm saying? Like, legendary or not, that Pokemon looks like something out of, like, a Final Fantasy game. It looks so awesome, right? Like, just, I absolutely fell in love with it the moment that I laid eyes on it. So ladies and gentlemen, this video is not over yet, because if I do recall in my initial announcement where I was gonna be doing a Q&A and a roast for you guys, I think I also mentioned that I was going to be responding to your guys' roasts back when we hit 300 subscribers, which was, god, it was way too long ago, and I apologize again for being an idiot and just completely forgetting to do a response to this. So that's what we're going to be doing here right now, ladies and gentlemen. So Red Soul Determination says, you're so short that even Napoleon's taller than you. Well, it wouldn't be too far off to imagine that, right? Because honestly, I'm only 5'6", right? Jet Rider says, you're so tiny that a grubbin looks giant. Oh my god. That's hilarious right there. Brent says, amazing content. You have a new subscriber. I think you should Google, okay, so a website here is the fastest way to grow your YouTube channel. Not really a roast, but okay, pretty cool. Game Master says, your beard's so long, you look like an Alolan Golem. And, we have Rom actually responded saying, LOL, saying someone looks like an Alolan Golem the way you did, not only roasts his beard, but his body, as Alolan Golem is fat, and, it can roll oh my god. Man, Rom, you just made that, like, roast 10 times more savage, man, what the hell? We have ourselves, Dark here saying, you want us to roast you with them spicy meat sausages you love so much? Come on, man. I'm a carnivore and I love spicy things, okay? Like, come on. Steven says, you pump less iron than broccoli puts in a person when they eat it. Well, to be fair, ever since the gyms have closed down because of the whole COVID-19 thing, I haven't been able to keep up with my fitness. I've been pumping like negative iron, man. Like, look, like my arms are so freaking like flabby, honestly. Like, look at this. You know what I'm saying? Nevi Network says, you're so weak you make Sunkern and Magikarp look like legendaries. Oh my god. Oh jeez. And we have ourselves a PokéLover 174 saying, you're so bad at Pokemon battling that Incineroar had to give up its belt to Metagross. Well, to be honest with you, it's like Incineroar and Metagross are two of my all-time favorite Pokemon, so I mean, alright, like, it wouldn't be that bad if I lost the belt to Metagross, because Metagross is my Gen 3 favorite, man. And we have ourselves Ghost Fox here saying, your teeth are so yellow, I'm surprised nobody uses it as condiments. Oh, shit. That's actually, like, really... That's good. That's good, man. And, whoa, okay. So, Rom posts here the same diss track that we responded to earlier on. Wow. I just gotta say again, man, that's, like, that's really good. I love that, that diss track there. Sora says, I gotta make a video out of this. Alright, well, I hope to see that video, you know? And Time Warp says, if laughter is the best medicine, your videos are the cure to the world. Well, I would, that's not even a roast, man. That's a compliment, man. Just kind of gives me the feels up in this, right? Sunshine McIntosh, says, your beard is so brown, it looks like poop, and it probably has some because of how long it is. Also, you're so lonely that you need, that you need people with better things to do, than roast, like burnt chicken. Okay. And Rom says, proper grammar would make your roast better. Well, I still got what Sunshine was saying, though. Alex Craig says, me sister hits harder than you. Well, I'm no boxer, right? I gotta get back into the swing of things. I gotta get back into the swing of things, man. Like, I really, really want this quarantine to, like, end and all that stuff. And also for no one to be at risk at the same time, but, you know, be business as usual. And for us to get back to, I want to get back to the gym, all right? And I want to get back to the gym and train my ass off like never before. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be it here for this video, or I should say this movie, honestly, because there was a lot to go over and a lot to respond to. And I really want to take the time right now to thank all of you guys for going out of your way to take part in the Q&A and roasting challenge. That right there was just honestly really, really fun to go over. You know what I'm saying? I definitely love you guys for all of this. Definitely got me some good laughs and a really big smile on my face. You know what I mean? So, with that being said, that's going to be here for the video. Thank you guys for watching. Have yourself a fantastic day or night, depending on your time zone. And I'll see you guys in the next one.